Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and I would like to welcome you to our new series, Introduction to Parametric Modeling. In this course, I would like to introduce you to the art of parametric modeling, which is the collection of techniques that we can use to generate three-dimensional form using rules and using algorithms. But why is this important? Well, if you have ever done, or if you ever used conventional 3D modeling software, you might be used to modeling form by, for example, following a sequence of commands, like one after the other, where you specify the series of operations that you want to follow and their values that would lead you to going from having nothing to having a complex three-dimensional object, right? And an example of this can be, for example, you can create a circle with a particular radius, and then you can extrude it with a particular height, and then maybe you can create a bunch of boxes and subtract those boxes to create some kind of tower with windows, maybe, something like that, right? This process, which I may refer to in this playlist as static modeling, is great if you're just doing quick and dirty, if you just have to do one off, if that's okay. However, if at any point in the future you need to make changes to that shape, then the process actually becomes very difficult because Your options are either undoing if you have the undo option and then redo your actions partially if you can, or make modifications of the object that has already been finished modeled, or simply just starting all over again, which of course is a lot of waste of time. So parametric modeling is a new paradigm in 3D modeling where what we do here is to explicitly design the rules and the sequences of operations, or in other words, the algorithm that lead to the creation of a particular three-dimensional form. And once that structure of relationships is there, then obtaining the final form is just as simple as choosing the values that we want for the parameters, parametric modeling, of our algorithm. And like, for example, the radius or the height of the extrusion or how many boxes, etc. And then just pressing a button and obtaining the result. And this is great, not just because it lets us go back to our designs and modify our choices, etc. But most importantly, because once the algorithm that generates this particular family of forms has been created, then exploring all the possible solutions that it can give you, it's just as simple as changing a couple numbers and then pressing that button and regenerating the form again. And this process, that process of exploration, is a huge advantage in design processes, especially in the early stages, because at those stages, you need to make decisions about the size, the shape, the appearance of certain objects, and having a quick way of iterating through a lot of versions is extremely efficient, and it's a really good help in making design decisions and thinking design. That is why parametric modeling is one of the cornerstones of computational design, and it helps us be more creative. But don't worry too much, because I'll get deeper into what parametric modeling is farther down in more videos in this series. So in this series, what I'm going to do is I'm going to assume that you're a complete beginner, that you know absolutely nothing. I'm going to start from scratch, and I'm going to teach you everything that you need to know to start applying parametric modeling in your own creative processes. In terms of software, we're going to be using Grasshopper, which is a visual programming language for the 3D modeling software called Rhinoceros from McNeil. However, the logics of what we're going to be learning in this series apply to many other similar environments, such as, for example, Dynamo for Revit, VVVV, Fusion 360, Touch Designer, Houdini. There's many modeling environments that follow similar patterns and similar logics. And furthermore, if what you will learn in this playlist will be a fantastic introduction to what's called algorithmic thinking, and it will be super helpful if you are actually interested at some point in moving on to the next step, which is writing your own algorithm using computer programming languages like we do in other series or in other videos in this channel. So what can you expect to learn on this series? Well, First of all, I will talk a lot about the different types of geometry that we can manipulate. I will give you very, very specific lectures on nerves geometry, which is a very popular model for freeform modeling. And we will use everything that we have learned to generate form and generate geometry that derives from the properties of nerves geometry. I will also teach you more fundamental geometry types, such as, for example, vectors, such as, for example, planes and their relations to nerves geometry. And I will teach you how to, for example, use vector algebra and use vectorial relations between geometry to do things such as, for example, modeling out of nerves geometry, or doing things such as, for example, solar analysis and calculate the incidence between different geometrical forms. This will be especially important when we do exercises where orientation in three-dimensional space will matter a lot. On top of that, I will talk a lot and very extensively about the topic of data, how to manipulate, how to control, and how to tame streams of lots of data. And in particular, I will show you how data is handled in different environments with a lot of emphasis on grasshopper and in particular data trees, which are the structures that are most common inside of grasshopper. And for examples, I will show you how to model complex three-dimensional structures so that we can understand the problems of matching different elements with each other and how that has repercussions in how we model three-dimensional stuff. That will also be applicable, for example, to exercises of triangulations of complex surfaces and then laying out that geometry flat so that we can 3D print it, we can laser cut it, we can draft it, etc. We will also learn how to do those techniques, for example, with intersections so that we can generate, for example, programmatically all the sectioning of a building with some kind of freeform geometry. On top of that, I will teach you a lot about how to create, manipulate, and control randomness in a way that it has some kind of meaning, and very often it represents some kind of the variability that is present in the natural physical environment around us. We will use that, for example, to mimic physical effects, such as, for example, this idea of the grass blowing through a field, or, for example, to create patterns that incorporate this notion of controlled randomness inside of them. And we will also kind of have a little bit of fun by creating, for example, simulations that have some kind of physics logic. For example, the randomness of how a brick wall can explode from a center point, for example. And we will also talk about other geometry types, such as, for example, meshes. I will show you how to work and manipulate and what are the fundamentals of mesh objects and how we can use some of their properties, for example, for visualization, such as this example where we used meshes to represent the incidence of a virtual sun on top of a surface. And we will also learn techniques that are very common in fabrication processes, such as, for example, slicing an object for 3D printing and generating a set of commands that looks like G code, which is the programming language that 3D printers use for 3D printing objects. And we will also learn very fun techniques, such as, for example, extracting color data from images and using that color data for generating patterns that we can laser cut or that we can etch, or how we could, for example, from a height field map, from a grayscale image representing height, we can recreate that height, that topography, and then we can do sectioning, we can do isocurves, and we can plot those in an XY plane. So that is going to be, in a nutshell, what you can expect from this course. The way this series is structured is on a playlist. If you're not on the playlist right now, then you may want to check the description on this video. You will find a link to the playlist. And my invitation is that you follow that. If you're a complete beginner and you have never touched Grasshopper, then that you follow that playlist from the beginning to the end, and that you follow alone doing, because it's going to be a combination of lectures, high-level lectures and a combination of practical exercises to illustrate the examples that you will learn. So my recommendation is that you have a couple screens, you have the video on one screen, and then you have Grasshopper and Rhino on the other one, and you follow along and you try things on your own, okay? And if you think what you learn is cool, maybe you want to consider liking the videos, you may want to consider subscribing to this channel, and you may want to turn on notifications to know when we publish new videos and also when we go live, because all these videos that you're going to see in this playlist have been recorded live in the presence of a lot of my friends in the community that were actually giving me suggestions and on that live chat and made the videos way better through their live input. So you're more than welcome to join the community on our Discord server as well. And less blah, 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 and less more learning. So I'm going to shut up and I'm going to let you now go into the playlist. I hope you have fun. I hope you learn a lot. And I will see you in this journey through parametric modeling. Thank you very much and see you on the videos.